We start from the last class, P versus NP, NP complete problem, NP hard problem, exponential problem, unsolvable problems. We try to understand today's class that what is P problem, what is NP complete, what is co-NP hard, what is P space problem, what is computable or not. All these things we try to from this class. Here I suggest you one Eric Deman from MIT, the particularly I am following his class there. It has faculty's YouTube video is available everywhere. You can see. So this is the point I have shown it. That is Eric Deman class. This is right now as per the Eric Deman. It is the computational complexity or computational difficulty. This is the line, and the first line. On the first quadrant, this is the P problem. That is, all I see is the P means polynomial problem, like your search, shortest path calculation in graph theory, any sorting algorithm like O(n) square, like insertion sort or n log n, quick sort or merge sort, or you could say the shortest path, Zeister's shortest path, all this graph theory, most of the problems. Or comes under P problem. This is easily solvable. I will give another name is the tractable problems. Another name. Now the comes after P, then the comes in another stage called NP. This is called NP. And this is the problem. These are the areas of problems. We are not sure whether it is P or whether it is NP. Like in 2002, one problem like AKS algorithm probably. This Agarwal, this A for Agarwal, he is very famous. Mahendra Agarwal, he also predict our COVID-19 model from IIT Kanpur. He got a Turing Award by his algorithm that primality detection. Whether you are given a big number, whether that number is prime or not, how to detect? One technique is you divide it by the prime numbers, like it must not be even. A number of digits should not be divisible by 21 like this, then it will be divisible by 3. It must not be end with 0 and 5 for obvious reasons that it will be divisible by 5. For any other odd numbers, you have to divide by 3, then 7, then 11, 13, 17, 23, 29, and all the subsequent prime numbers till the number root over 9, till it's doesn't divide, we'll say the number is prime. But this is a very this is the problem is not polynomial problem. This problem is comes exponential problems. So but he tested it that it can be done in polynomial problems. So this is the prime number problem. It has been shifted in 2002 onwards. So year 2002 it has been shifted to P problem. So there are lots of problems are there. Now there are some typical problems are there. This is at the border point, that is this NP ends here, is a border point, and this border point, the problems are together, like click problem, the factoring problem, like subset cover problem, we'll tell it. This problem, one of the problem can be solved in a polynomial time, the whole problem can be collapsed into the polynomial time. This is one of the toughest problem. So this the gap may diminish. This is the very interesting part of algorithmic complexity. And by the way, you might ask, what is our Turing halting problem? Turing halting problem at the right inmost problem. That is the at the rightmost end problem. This is the Turing halting problem. Because Turing halting problem is totally everybody decided it is unsolvable because no algorithm for it. But there are many problems between it. Let's try what are these problems. Like say Rubik cube. All you know the Rubik group. Rubik cube is basically a polynomial problem. Then there comes Sudoku. You have a Sudoku. This problem with simple 9 by 9, it is very easy. If it is a, but it is exponential problem. Another thing we must see what is this is polynomial problem. This is NP problem. NP means not polynomial. NP means a non-deterministic Turing machine can solve the problem in polynomial time. What does it mean? Say everywhere you take the right guess, then you solve the problem, then you call it not NP problem. And what is NP complete problem is it is very difficult to find it, but whenever the solution is there, you can quickly check it by polynomial time. Take the case of Sudoku. Sudoku, if you are given, if getting a solution is hard, if you say 9 by 9, it can be 81 by 81 is hard, but once the solution is given, we can quickly check it by within a millisecond or within a second. So that is the characteristics of NP-complete problem. Like chess, say if you say 2 8 by 8 player is playing a chess, maybe in the middle of the play, maybe you are taking our Vishwanathan Anand is playing with Bobby Fischer. Though they have not played together, but they are greats of the chess. Bobby Fischer is one time the world champion in 1972, perhaps. Vishy was champions 2-3 times, Vishwanathan. So if they say keep and play chess, because chess can be played on internet also. So if the chess is played in the middle of the play, you just try to give a winning chance of Vishwanathan Anand, and you say this is the move you should give it. But whether that is NP complete problem? No, because chess, every piece is can move maybe 8 times, 10 different ways. So every move can be 10 different ways, so it is an exponential problem. So every move we can count it. And another thing, whenever they have given a solution, no, your queen should move one step away or your horse should move 2.5 steps. So again, by checking also, you need another tough problem. So whenever this kind of solution, when the problem is the solution, you have to check it a long amount of time. This is not NP complete problem. This problem is called exponentially hard problem. This is much harder than NP complete problem. So NP complete problem here at the border point between NP, it doesn't mean it is the hardest problem. The hardest problem definitely one of the Turing halting problem. All over the computer scientists have decided that this is the utmost problem. No other problem can be solved this. Turing halting problem, the other problem I have told, that jigsaw puzzle. So you have various jigsaws, how to match these jigsaws. There is no algorithm. These are all uncomputable. And then there comes the NP complete problem. All the 3000 problems comes together. But our chase is exponential problem. It is much harder than NP hard problem. Why? Because whenever you give a solution to a chase solution, even if checking, you need exponential time. So really that is the problem. So there comes that your chess problem comes here. It's exponentially hard, and this is the gap whether it's a purely research topic, whether they will collapse or not, whether this P, if P is equal to NP, then they will collapse. The most of the computer scientists doesn't believe P equal to NP. So there is a gap, and this is the NP complete problem. This is the NP hard problem. And these are the exponential problem, like chess problem I have told. Another exponential problem that cannot be simplified, you know, Tower of Hanoi. It is, if you have a 3 disk, a 2 to the power 3 disk minus 1, that is a number of movements you require. Same the 4 disk, 2 to the power 4 minus 1. So this is a typical exponential problem. It cannot be make it a polynomial reduction. You cannot make a P problem. Its verification also is easy, but verification is a Tower of Hanoi is very easy, but chase is not so easy. So these are the characteristics of the problem, and there is all problems are exponentially hard. So all this thing you can say it like from here onwards, like whenever you have these are the intractable problems. So whenever the problem goes with we subdivided it. One is P problem, one is NP complete problem here. This is exponential problem. Exponential is harder than NP problem. And then is another problem that is called R. These are, you can take it, the R is a recursive problem. R is for recursive. Yes, that is the answer. As per the Eric Deman, this is the complexity scale. This is the complexity. Because the most of the computer science problem, you have to measure its complexity, and it is a dynamic thing. Every year it is changes. So, but you always, whenever you have a problem, you all know that the problem complexity of a problem should not depend on the language, because all high level language is the same complexity. But complexity is how you divide your algorithm states and data structure. That will affect the complexity. The easiest of the P problem, that is polynomial problem, like your searching, sorting, minimum minimum path, Dijkstra, these are all comes under n squared, log n, n cube, matrix multiplication, whenever the number of problem size goes to the bottom, not over. Then comes the NP problem. NP problem is not, NP doesn't mean not polynomial. NP means non-deterministic Turing machine can solve in polynomial time. Say every time the non-deterministic Turing machine take a lucky guess and that guess solve it. If you say it is not lucky, it may not take unlucky, every time it is unlucky, all the movements are unlucky, then it is not solvable. That is, then it is not an NP problem. But if it is solved by a lucky algorithm by every time, say you think luck is with them, then if it is there, then we call a NP complete problem. What is the characteristics of NP complete problem? Characteristics of NP complete problem is trying to finding a solution is very difficult, but whenever you are given a solution, you can quickly check it. Like the case of Sudoku. Sudoku, try to get it, say if a 9 by 9, the computer can do it very quickly, but if you get, say 81 square by 81 square, so even computer takes time, but when the solution is given, even a human can do it within a second. So that is the characteristics of NP complete problem. NP complete problem is verification is much quicker, and there are interesting cases of 3000 problems, NP complete problems, coming from last day we have closed the factoring problem from Michael Sipser lecture. Then there comes the click problem. Click problem, you know, in a say in a Facebook, so in our class, you know, class in Facebook, you want to select your friends who are friends with each other, otherwise not. So if you are calling a party in the evening, see if they do not know each other earlier, then there may be some problem. So that is a you want to, and you want to find the maximum click. Maximum click, you want to know, see if you have 70 students in your class, if they are all Facebook, it is quite happened that all are not Facebook friends with each other. So you want to call a party, all the parties, say you have to try from the 2 click, 3 click, 5 click, 7 click, 8 click, maybe in a class you might lucky to find 10 click, maximum 10 click, 10 are mutually friend to each other, or maybe 20 click, but that is very hard, because if the node size is 100, to find a click, it take maybe 10 years for a computer. So it looks simple, but it is not so simple. But if you are given a solution that this is your click size, then you can verification very easy. So click is one factoring problem that last class we have discussed. Say 13 into 7, 91 is very easy. And whenever you are given a 91, it takes certain amount of time. So if you have a big number, apparently a odd number, not ending with 5 or 0, because if whenever you have 5 or 0, that means it's divisible by 5, it is an odd number, then it is first of all whether it is a prime number or not, or whether it is a prime number. If it is a prime number, then it is a composite number. What are the two factors? So this is a very tough problem. So I have discussed it. We have a 309 digit, one 309, and it is still not solved. But whether then you have to test it whether it's a prime number or not. Even if it's not prime number, then you have to, what is your composite factors? So these are the typical NP complete problem. But once you are given the number, two big numbers, you can quickly check it out by through hand or computer. So this is a typical case of NP complete problem. Then another is a problem, two problems we'll discuss after some times. So this is it. These are the areas. You call the border region. This is the there the come exponential problem comes, and here is the NP complete comes. NP complete is around 3000 problems are there. If you find a solution in one of them, all can be solved. All can be, if you find a solution in polynomial time, definitely. If you can solve, because these are all solvable problems, this is not unsolvable problem. Till Turing halting problem, the Turing halting is unsolvable. Beyond this, before this, all are solvable problems. But maybe NP complete, maybe NP hard, like exponential, like this. What do we have to know? So where we are, this is NP complete, but here the region, this is the region NP complete and P, there are problems here. But if you can find, either you can find the problem to here, NP complete, and either the here. So like 2002 primality detection, they move the problem here. Okay, and now comes the exponential problem. Exponential problem is our chase problem. So chase problem in the between, say our Vishwanathan Anand and Bobby Fischer in making it a dream chess tournament, and maybe after 10 moves you want to suggest Vishwanathan, this is the move. But even if you made the move, to verification it will take another exponential of time. So here the chase problem is the hardest problem. There are lots of problems like Tower of Hanoi. You cannot solve it with a few steps. So you know it will require 7 steps. But verification is easy. But chase problem verification is also not easy. A lot of problems are exponentially hard problem. These are the exponential. Typical formula of exponentially hard problem is 2 to the power n to the power c. C is a constant. Okay. Like our polynomial problem, O, big O, n to the power c. What is our polynomial problem complexity? Here we have the polynomial complexity O, n to the power c. C is a constant. C is a constant 1, 2, 3 like this. This is the polynomial problem. Here, the complexity is O to the power c. You might ask why not 3, why not 4, but because our computer science is basically everywhere you go for yes, no answer. So, everywhere you can see the base is always 2 and N is the number of choices you make and C is the another constant. And then comes the R, that is a recursive. And this is a Turing-Halting problem, no solve. So it is not in R also. It is the toughest problem. Okay. So now let's come to the. This is the gentleman called Eric Deman. I will send you the YouTube link. And MIT is very famous because he's the most famous for algorithmic complexity. You must know. This is our contribution from our automata class to your algorithmic class. And this is a P versus NP. Whether P and NP equal or not, this is, I told you, centuries one of the biggest problem. If you can solve it, whether P is equal to NP or NP is greater than P, you can get $1 million prize from Clay Institute. It's still open. So, this is one of the hottest topic, and everywhere computer scientists are working on it from the 1960s and 70s. Yeah. So, next is, this is the area, this is I covered. This is a P problem, that is easy problem. This is P problem, is very easy problem. This is NP. This area is most interesting, NP complete. This area, it is proven, it cannot be P. And there are some problem, we are still like 2002 primality detection of prime numbers. One of them, our Mr. Mahendra Agarwal, who is now predicting our curve from IIT Kanpur. He's a famous, very famous scientist. He got the Turing Award. So, AKS algorithm, he proved that any prime number can be proven that it is a prime number, it is a P algorithm. Earlier it was thought as a NP, but now it is a P problem. So day by day, some computer scientists are proving some algorithm P and some algorithm to NP complete. NP complete problem, one good characteristic is what is NP, non-deterministic Turing machine can solve the problem by lucky chances. Everybody is lucky, he got it. That is an NP complete problem. Whenever you give a solution, we can only within a polynomial time you can see it, the solution is valid. But this is exponential. Whenever you try to find the solution, that is exponential. But verification is polynomial. Another interesting characteristic is like last class I have discussed the factoring problem from Michael Sisson class. And another problem is 3-sat program. I discuss in my next class 3-sat. 3-sat problem, easy problem. It's a 3 variables. It's basically a clause. The clauses are ANDed together. Each individual clause consists of 3 literals. The literals is x1, x2, x3. This can be x1 and x2 can be positive or negative. Positive or negative. Like x1 or x1 bar, x2, x2 bar, x3. This is all basically called a variable. Then these 3 variables to or together makes a clause, and this clause, this x1, x2 can be happen in any clause, they are ANDed. Then you have to calculate for every variable all, true, false combination. This is typically exponential problem. This is not a polynomial problem. And every NP complete problem can be solved by a 3-sat problem. That is beauty. So if 3-sat problem, you can solve it in P, then the all NP complete problems can be solved in P. But 3-sat problem is 100% prove that it cannot be done in a P. So this NP complete problem is that interesting. There are lots of problems we are proving to NP complete problem. There are around 3000 problems all over domain, maybe genetic area, maybe graph, maybe any other domain. They are basically converted to a three set problem. So that is great. That is very interesting area. The interest. And then other problems are this NP hard. NP hard means that is exponentially you can find answer, but you cannot check it by a very polynomial way. So like I told you, the exponential problem, the chase, even if given an answer, that you have to need time. So this is the areas of the problem. So next, this is more like here NP hard. I'll call these are the problems I'll call traveling salesman problem. I discussed this is one of the NP hard problem. Two types of deterministic, non-deterministic, and sometimes you see there is no algorithm available, like Turing halting problem, like whether two context-free language ambiguity is there or not. These are the undecidable problems. There is no algorithm. This is very interesting cases. Recognizing a design covered. This is the exponential problem or R. What is NP problem? A decision problem solvables in polynomial time via lucky algorithm, as per Eric Deman. A non-deterministic model algorithm makes guesses, always guesses, and yes or no, and guesses are guaranteed to lead to yes. So this is NP problem. Like it takes this exponential problem, always take or sometimes get yes answer. So this is the curve I have put it in a board. This is polynomial NP, and here this region between NP and P, this is doubtful. Can be collapsed. This is a computational difficulty, or you can say computational complexity. This is the halting problems comes here. Most decision problems are uncomputable. I told you, because most of the computer science problem taking care of both kinds of problem, optimization problem and decision problem. Last few classes I have impressed upon you. Optimization problems, you are trying to find the exact answer of say particular variable x is equal to either 1.33 or 1.43 or 1.23. Now, all these optimization problems can be converted to decision problems, like I want to say whether x is greater than 1.5 or less than 1.5, then I say whether x is greater than 1.4 or less than 1.4. So all optimization problem can be decision problems. So decision problems is more general. And another interesting fact is most of the decision problems are not solvable. Sometimes we do not know the answer. Like one of the decision problem is Turing halting problem. There are lots. I really don't know what will happen tomorrow. This is also decision problem. It is whatever the weather forecast and all these things. There are always indecision there, so that we cannot predict. That's good. That is the life is interesting. So most decision problems are uncomputable. Like in 1965, these are the first algorithm is this is. Now the factoring still there. You determine if the number is prime, it is 1965, it is a slow problem, but and this also discrete Fourier transform. These two will shift it to the first. Yeah. Now see discrete Fourier transforms comes in the first, then in 2002, this Agarwal problem they come. So right now, this is polynomial problems. These are problems. It is a 2002. It is a factoring, it is still Michael Sipser factoring, travel salesman problem. We all know. So these are another three gentlemen. It is Leonid Levin, Cook and Leonid Levin, two together. They proved this. There are certain problems are there which is very hard to solve. But once the solution is given, they can be checked. That is the NP complete problem. NP complete problem is this is like this problem, Michael Sipser class. If the two number, it is easy to get multiplication. And whenever you are given this number, very, very tough to do. So that is the basics of any security. We use the security that way. Yeah. This is the click problem, you know. This is a, so that we want to say these three are connected. These are not connected. This is a click problem. This is the three click. This is a four click. This is a five click. In this, you have to find what is the click size. What is the maximum click size? This is a NP complete problem. bigger click problem. Say finding a, it is also yesterday discussed last class, it will take a huge time. If you need 100 nodes, 100 nodes is moderate. To find the click, it's huge time is required. Like all this needle in a haystack problem, our algorithm should be smart enough. We need a sort of magnet to get it. So we have to choose algorithm, otherwise it will take infinite amount of time. Like all these problems are there, P versus NP. This is a very interesting question. Still, it is not solved. Yeah, this is easily solvable, or P. This I have the factoring and click. This is Kevin Cook. This is a transformer. That last class is transformer or reducibility. Whether that is one of the syllabus in your automata theory is there. This whole set of problem, like NP complete problem, can be reduced to a three-set problem or click problem. There, so that if any problem can be solved, this can be solved by other problems also in polynomial time. So you do not have to individually solve the problems. If click problem or three-set problem can be solved in polynomial time, so you can map any other 3000 problem, NP complete problem, to that. So these are the complexity classes. There are many more complexity classes will be there. In fact, I will try to cover the next class. We are basically P. This is NP intersection of complementary NP, and we are basically here. We believe this model. We'll clear in the next class. Yeah, this is the all classes can be. This is the all NP complete problem can be merged to this. Yeah, reduction. I have told you, reduction is a polynomial time algorithm that converts a solution of one problem to the another problem that I've discussed. We see the what is the independent set, vertex cover and click. We'll go to this. What is this? This is a click problem. This is the click, maximum click. You cannot come, this one you cannot be read. So these three are connected to each other. And this is independent set problem. What is independent set problem? It is very easy. We have to select the nodes which do not have any common connection. Like here, it is a graph. The red color node doesn't have any common connection. So this can be, or maybe another set can be these three can be. So this is the maximum independent red one. See, it's a bipartite graph. Bipartite graph is easy. These are left hand side are all red. This is a bipartite graph. This graph, these are the red signs are the independent set. Independent set means the set of nodes which does not have any adjacent node. It can be easily converted to three color problem. We will see. So coloring problem. This is independent set. See, is a vertex cover. Another interesting area is a vertex cover means you have to select the nodes so that you can cover all the vertices. You have to select the nodes, all the vertices. Like here, if I select there, it can be adjacent, but it select the nodes, all the edges. It covers all the edges. It covers all the edges so that you have to select the nodes, that minimum number of nodes which can cover all the edges. Say bipartite. You see here, here, and here. And one of the interesting thing is the vertex cover and independent set are basically mutually exclusive. So if you can find it out the vertex cover, you can automatically cover the independent set. We'll see. So they are basically same problem. So this is the graph. This is the independent set problem. This is the graph. The independent, these four are independent set. And other than four, this three is the vertex cover solution. So what I want to show that this problem, vertex cover, independent set, and the click, all are the NP problem, NP complete problem. But by this diagram, we want to show that this is a graph. The independent set are these blue nodes, this 1, 2, 3, 4, and the vertex cover is independent set means they are not adjacent to each other, the maximum size. And the vertex cover is, the definition is, a vertex of those nodes which cover all the edges. So here it covers these four edges, here it covers these edges, and here it covers these edges. So these three red nodes are covering all the edges. And you see the independent set edges are vertex are complementary. So if you from the graph, other graphs are, so that is the reason. The basically the problems looks different, but they are actually solving. So if we if you are given independent set calculation, if we calculate the vertex cover, so you can definitely solve it by independence. So that is the beauty of this NP complete problem. Any question, please? Any question? Lot of time. Any question you can give. So here, P problems solve problems solvable in polynomial time, exponential problems solvable in exponential time, and here the 2 to the power n.
Sir, is it possible to optimize the exponential program to polynomial program?
Yeah, that is always a research case. Always it is a exponential problem, like AKS primality test, that is exponential problem. They solve it to polynomial problem in only 2002, year 2002. So it is always solved, but it is a research problem. So what is the basic exponential problems? Exponential problem are those problems where each variable takes any position, like three set configuration. We have a multiple clauses. The clauses consist of a literals, and the literals can go true, false independently. But whenever you want to take the value of the full sentence, you have to, because they are all by AND clause. So because it's a AND clause, you have to independently look into the every clause, because all say 30 clauses are ANDed. Each clauses you have to go for their own. If anyone the one, you take is a one. So in that case, you see, say you have to take exponential amount of time, like our Tower of Hanoi. So if you want to solve it, you have exponential, like chess game or any such game where the multiple number of moves, you have to try the multiple moves. That's the exponential problem. It cannot be polynomial. It can be policy. It is chess. If you want to win it by force, no, I have to win. Then you have to go to the end stage and say, I am taking your king or queen. Yeah. So that is a heart. But that is a that is not a game. So if it's a game, you have to put your moves. Then other party can move your moves. So they have exponential. I have a 16 pieces. I have a every pieces maybe 2, 4, or 6. So every pieces have, these are combinations. So these are the typical exponential problem. So you have to first map it, the problem, whether it is a polynomial problem or exponential problem. Yes, one can, whatever it can be done, sometimes for approximate solution. Sometimes you know it is exponential problem, it is very difficult, like our traveling salesman problem, it is a factorial and all. But we can go for minimum, for approximate. So we can take some steps so that we can try to reduce it polynomial problem. That is called the approximate solution. Yeah, that is one, the approximate solution. Then dynamic programming is one technique. Dynamic programming is a divide and conquer, but they make a small parts, take some assumptions, then go to the bigger parts, like Fibonacci number calculation by the dynamic programming. That is one of the popular topic in your data structure and algorithm class. You know the Fibonacci number. If you go to the Fibonacci number by the recursion way, that is very exhaustive and very time consuming. And but if you put the dynamic programming, so you should save your earlier result in an array, and whenever you further result you want to look up, you look up from your stored array. That is interesting technique. You if you are given a Fibonacci number 41, then you don't have to go again 0, 1, 2. You, once you have done it, that will be stored in your primary memory as a array. And then if you want to say 41 is there, somebody wants to give 46, then you start from 41, not from 1. That is called the dynamic programming. That is also a divide and conquer strategy. There are various techniques. Another technique is randomization. You can start at random point and reach to there. I think shortest paths, you can see some flavor. Randomization gives a very good technique. These are all approximate solutions to get it. Any good question? Any other question you can ask, please? We have little time there. you can ask the question. Question answer should be there, otherwise it is difficult. Please ask question. Any question? Is it visible, audible? Anyone? Aomika is there? Aomika? Aomika is
yes,
there?
Sir.
Question, any question? Any question? There should be some questions. Say, why the undecidable problem? Why the there's too many questions in configuration grammar, context-free grammar, whether two grammar generates the same sentence is an undecidable question. So first you try to understand undecidable means what? Undecidable, you don't have any algorithm. That is Turing halting problem. Turing halting problem, you might wonder, say, I have written a small program. I know 100% that it will stop and get the answer. But that you cannot guarantee for all other programs. What I have to say, maybe incorrect programs, the bugs are there. And every program can have bugs. What is bugs? Bugs means a program, not intentional, but it works most of the time, but for a particular input, it might go forever. So that is, you can think that you cannot write a all-purpose program whose input is another program and data and say that program will stop or halt or not. So this is the first step in 1936, Turing put out that this is a halting problem. And this is the rightmost limit of our problem. And before this, all the problems are solvable. Solvable means exponential. And that is it. So that problem is unsolvable. Till we do not have further tougher problem. Like we know we have infinity. We know we have two types of infinity. One infinity, say, you can say smaller infinity. One infinity, bigger infinity. Say natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can think any number you can have. It is a big number, but this is not so big if you think a number, real number between 1 and 2. See, if you pick a real number between 1 and 2 or 0, 1, basically, maybe 0, 1, same thing. I say 0.001. They say, no, I have a 0.501. They say 0.1601. So, there are much more number can be packed into 0 and 1 than the natural number. So, there you can now, this is enumerable number. You can number it. But this is number of real numbers into this, our 0 to 1 is very, very big. From there, we can come to a conclusion. See, you can write a program. Ultimately, program, I have told you, ultimately, programs gives a dot out or a dot exe. That a dot out is basically a string of 0 and 1s. Okay? And it is giving yes or no, whether it's 1, yes, 1, and false, no. So if it's 1 and 0, and it gives certain number of 1, certain number of 0. So there, number of options of 1 and 0, if you put a decimal point in front of this, it is a real number. Okay, it's a real number with a fraction. Okay, and your program is basically integer number. So this program is nothing but ultimately a big integer number, and it giving a output in 0 or 1, basically the real number space, if you put point inside, outside, before that, then your program, how many programs can be? The programs can be set of natural numbers. Any program you can fix the natural numbers to it. See, if you have a 10 line program, there's a big number generate, you put a natural number, say 1001, and it gives output. So this set of natural numbers, whenever you are mapping to real number, so that is cannot be 1:1. So that is the thing, corresponding. That is definitely not 1:1. So that is the thing, it is the basic logical block of this is undecidable. The Turing halting problem is undecidable problem. Next class, I'll prove the various NP complete problems. So this thing I tell in a summary, this is the complexity curve. Right now, whenever you in the algorithmic class, in any class, you try to complexity here. If it is P, you are very fortunate. Like our not only Turing-Halting problem, say any context-free grammar, whether they decide the same language or not, that is undecidable. So that is also same, comes it here. Oh, okay, very good thing. NP-complete problem, one example is context-sensitive grammar. parsing is NP complete. If you see context sensitive, context free grammar, it can be done ONQ, that is a P. Context free grammar ONQ. This is our regular grammar is P, ON. Context free ONQ maximum, but context sensitive, you see NP complete. So it is here. And then type 0 grammar, it will be here. Okay. Type 0 grammar, parsing should be here. Tough. Not NP complete, much tougher. And this area, beyond this area, is uncomputable. No algorithm for this. Best example, Turing-Hartig problem, our two context-free grammar, whether same or not. There are lots of problems. In fact, most of the problems are the uncomputable. These are all decision problems. Why you have taken decision problems, you know. By decision problem, you can take the optimization problems also as well.
Sir, how regular languages comes under P?
Yeah, regular languages comes under P because you can solve it by ON time. Because regular language, either you have left recursive rule or right recursive rule. Okay, so by expanding one at a time, you can go. That is a P problem. Because whenever you see, if there are n terminals in a regular language and you have some rules, okay, by expanding the rules, you don't have to take chances. Like in context-free grammar, we have to take chances. Okay, this rule is fire, no, it is not, back and forth. That is called back and forth technique. But we prove that back and forth we should not take. We remove left recursion and some other technique. Through LL1 grammar, we can solve it. On LR1 technique, we know the left recursion may be there, but if the grammar is inherently unambiguous, though we can solve it by ON. In regular grammar, we don't have to take anything. In regular grammar, if you take the from the S start variable, you start expanding, then you will get your sentence. You should. And that is the number of try will be ON, not beyond this. ON. And for this thing, context-free grammar, it can be O2N-1 by Chomsky's normal form. Because any context-free grammar can be done in Chomsky's normal form, we have shown that a tree can have two child, by 2N-minus steps you can get it, but that is also linear. O2N-1 is basically ON. But there are some context-free grammar, particularly ambiguous context-free grammar, those come only non-deterministic context-free grammar. First of all, ambiguous context-free grammar cannot be in deterministic context-free grammar. Ambiguous context-free grammar like typical I, whether I equal to J or J is equal to K, AI, BJ, CK, the formula, either which rule can fire, then the complexity can be maximum O in cube. Okay, and that is it. And another is non-ambiguous grammar like parenthesis grammar, that is non-deterministic PDA, that is ONQ by CYK algorithm. But the scenario changes in the context sensitive grammar like A to the power N, B to the power N, C to the power N. Then your parsing complexity is NP complete. Now today's class you should know what is NP complete. NP complete is the farthest, toughest NP problem, but they are combined together. Okay, there are a bunch of problems. If one of them can be solved, it can be solved. Like in our graph problem, one is the click size, click, how they are connected. Another is the vertex cover. In a graph, we want to select the nodes which cover all the edges. And another is independent set. Independent set means, say again, you are a party. You ask your friends, don't come with the bosses. Without bosses, they are independent set. The independent set and vertex cover, they are complementary each other. That I have to show. So that is the reducibility. So this is the in algorithm class. Generally, we try to have a known algorithm and unknown algorithm. We try to map to known algorithm in polynomial amount time. If it's a polynomial time, you can convert to this algorithm. Then it is also same technique. If we can prove it to any problem, to NP complete problem, that problem is NP complete. If we can prove in polynomial time to known polynomial problem, then that problem is polynomial problem. So you can, you always try to map the problem to the known problem in that domain. That is the idea. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Bye.